Hello, and welcome to the Hello, It's Me App Inventor video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'll be going through some of the basic building blocks of App Inventor, and we'll be creating a simple app. To get started, we need to create a new project. To do this, go to the upper left-hand corner and click Start a New Project. You'll be prompted to put in a name. Let's call it Hello, It's Me, and press OK. This should automatically open the new blank project titled Hello, It's Me. Now, what do we want our app to do? Well, for this app, we want it so that when you press a button with a smiley face on it, it will say a pre-recorded voice of Hello, It's Me. This will use several components, but first we need to import the proper media. Well, what we're going to need is an image of a smiley face to put on the button, and we're going to want a recording of yourself saying the words, Hello, it's me. In the description of this video, we do have some pre-recorded words, as well as an image if you'd like to upload those instead. Once you have the media set up, go to the media bin here and upload the files. You can do this by clicking on Upload File and then choosing the file that is in your computer. Once you've uploaded both the recording and the smiley face, you should see both of them down here in the media drawer. Now that we're set up on that, let's take a look at exactly what this screen is. The screen that you see right here is the designer screen for App Inventor. This is where you drag in all the components that you'll be using for your app. The image of this phone right here is a representation of what your device will look like when you actually finish the app and try it out on your own mobile device. Now, for the app, we're going to need a button that you can press, a label to show exactly what should be done, and a player to play the recording. Let's drag all of those in. The button you can find in the user interface drawer. And if you click and drag that in, it will show up on the screen and in the components section. This just keeps a list of what components you have in your app. Now, we're going to need a label. This is also in the user interface section of the palette. Click and drag that in below the button. And finally, we're going to need a player. The player is not in the user interface section, but actually in the media section. If you click and drag that in, you'll see that it doesn't show up, but it is in the components. And if you scroll down to below, you can see that the player is actually a non-visible component. This means that nothing actually shows up on the screen, but it still works behind the scenes to play your sound. Now we have all three components of the app that we're going to need, but the preview screen doesn't look very good or professional. We can actually go into the properties of all of these components and change them to look a lot better. If you click on button 1, its properties tab will show up on the side. These have various properties that you can change for the looks of the button, including the background color, the font size of the text, and its height and width. We're going to change some of these. For example, let's have the button take up more of the screen. Let's set its height to 300 pixels and set its width to fill parent. Fill parent just takes up the entire width of the screen. Now, we want the image of the button to actually be the smiley face. So if you go into the image field, click on it, and click on the smiley face image that you uploaded, you can see that it shows up here. And we don't need text anymore, so if you go into the text field and just delete it, we have our completed button. Now, let's change the properties of the label. All we want for the label is for it to show the words, Hello, it's me, the name of our app. So let's click on it and take a look at its properties. First of all, we're going to want to change the text to say, Hello, it's me. But let's make it a little bit more visible. Let's set its font size here to 26 and set it to be centered. We can set its width to also fill parent, just like we did for the button. This will put it in the very center of the screen. And we can change the color of the background and the text. You can do it however you would like, but I'm going to set the background color to blue and the text color to white. That way you can really see it. And finally, let's take a look at the properties of the player. The player doesn't have very many properties because it's only there to play the sound we want. But what's very important is we need to specify what sound it's going to play. This you can find in the source. The source says exactly what the player is supposed to play. So let's click on it and have it play the recording of the words, "Hello, it's me." And now you have all of the properties set up in the designer view. Let's go on to the blocks. Okay, so you've set up the entire visible designer component of your app, but we still haven't yet specified how the button and player will interact. We want it so that when you press the button, the player will play, but we don't have that interaction yet. To do that, we're going to have to move from the designer to the blocks. Go to the upper right-hand corner and click on the blocks button. This brings us to the blocks section of App Inventor. This is where you can actually code functionality of your app. Well, what do we want it to do? We want it so that when you press the button, it plays the sound that you pre-recorded. Let's check out the blocks that we have here. These are the built-in blocks that appear in every App Inventor project. It has basic things like math and texts and lists so that you can have lists of objects. But we're not going to be using that in this project. We're actually going to be looking at the custom blocks here. And as you can see, there's a set of blocks for the button, the label, and the player, the three components that we put into this app. Let's take a look at the button blocks. And you can see the very top one, when the button is clicked, do something. That's what we want. We want stuff to happen when the button is clicked. So we'll drag it in to our viewer. What do we want to happen when the button is clicked? Well, we want the player to play. So let's take a look in the player blocks and see what we can find. And here it is. It will say call player1.start. And if we drag that in, it fits perfectly. And so this is the entire coding functionality of the app. When the button is clicked, play the player sound. If you've made it this far, then congrats. You finished the Hello It's Me app. You can test it out by going to Connect and click on the AI Companion to connect your mobile device using the MIT App Inventor Companion app. It should work so that when you press the button with your finger, it will say the words, "Hello, it's me." There are plenty of ways to continue expanding the app, and I encourage you to think of ways to do so. Here are some suggestions. You could add a second button with a different voice recording for another person. You could also change the background color or change the colors of the different buttons and labels. You could even add the recorder component to the App Inventor workplace and have it record your voice inside the app so that you don't have to do it outside from the computer. These are just some options. Feel free to come up with your own. And overall, congratulations on completing the Hello It's Me App Inventor app.